How we doing, guys? Myself, Chris Pretty, OBE, hitting you with a quick one. Real talk, true season. Welcome to another story time. The story of time is about when I took my first trip to Jamaica. Yes, guys, I said it, when I took my first trip to Jamaica. Now, I'm Jamaican. You get me? You don't know what I mean? Why? What you dealing with? Now, I'm English Jamaican, not fully Jamaican. So, it's funny because my granddad passed away, and everyone in my family was going over there. And I knew my granddad, but I didn't know my granddad. Do you understand what I'm trying to say? Because my mum kept me away from that side of the family. Long story, but do you know what I'm trying to say? So we get out there now, and I'm meeting my family. This is the first time I'm meeting a lot of families. So, you know, when you go christening, tell the truth, fair enough, let's break it down. You know, when you go funerals and christenings and family functions, you start meeting your brothers and sisters. Come on, how much of us have met half brothers and sisters at a family function? Right, who's your dad? My dad's blah, blah. That's my dad too. How old are you? I'm 17. How old are you? I'm 15. Right, you're my brother still. Right, cool, say, mad thing. So I'll get over there now to Jamaica. I'm gassed, innit? But before I got over to Jamaica, I didn't want to go. You know what I'm saying? Let's keep it real. Man didn't want to go, you get me? Because I watched Ross Kemp, and my man was talking bare crud. See, bare yardy man shooting up the place and everything. I said, leave it, yeah? Now, my family from Kingston, Spanish town. So those that don't know about Jamaica, you know it's the Gaza. You get me? Man thought I was going to, Montego Bay, you get me? You know what I'm saying? Just go and chill out and relax and enjoy life. And nah. So the worst thing about it is, this is how the story starts. So the story starts where we get on the plane. Now we get on the plane, because mind you, at first, I didn't know that man wasn't going to Kingston. You understand what I'm trying to say? Let me break it down anyway. So man fly on the plane. We get off at Montego Bay. You get me? So I'm like, yeah, touchdown Jamaica. Get me? I'm looking at palm trees. I'm looking at the sunshine. I said, yo, Jamaica's looking nice. Still, you know, Rasta. So my cousin comes to pick us up. He's got this big car now. So he's like, yeah, we're going to have to drive to Nan's house. You get me? So mind you, it's my cousin from Jamaica. So I'm like, go. Jumping out of the car. We're driving now. Man said to me, it's going to be about 2 to 3 hours. For those who know, man's now driving from Montego Bay to Kingston. It's a long thing. I don't know why we didn't take a direct flight to Kingston. It's a madness. We'll get through it anyway. So I'm driving through and I'm looking at the scenery and I'm like, yo, man, I'm home, man. Jamaica, man. As soon as I touch down, rice and peas, straight away. This is where it's come from, yeah? Man need to go to granny's yard. I need to go to a shack. I need to go to someone's backyard and get the real rice and peas from Jamaica. So I'm in both. Looking at the scenery now, I'm gassed. We crossed one bridge. I can't even remember what the bridge was called. For those Jamaicans that know what the bridge is called, comment below. You know what's there. So we crossed this bridge. Listen to me. When man crossed the bridge, man start see shanty. Man start see Gaza. Man start see things no more palm trees. There was no more nice scenery, bruv. It was just strictly man them walking on the road. You get me? Beer chest, you get me? Mask over their face. You look like baba. Man started to gritch my bag. Where is man going? You know the one's there. Man took her left. Man took her right. Man took her left. Man took her right. Before you know it, I'm in deep town Kingston. The thing is, where I'm at, you get me? Yeah, people on the roadside. I'm like, okay. The vibe's a bit different. No, you get me? I'm like, all right, cool. But I'm with my cousins. I'm with my family. So I know I'm good. You get me? Get to my nan's house now. Everyone's pulling up their bags. They're the hotel's fully booked. So now, I'm bugged already. What do you mean the hotel is fully booked? You know what's there? So they're like, rah, some's got to stay at Nan's house and some's got to stay at my other auntie's house. That's a little bit further deeper in Kingston. Listen to me, bruv. My nan said straight after that, they come 2 weeks ago and they shoot up the yard. Who shoot up the yard, nan? Who? Where? Here. Someone was shooting around here. Listen, I left my bags there on the porchway. You think I'm joking? I left my bag on the porch where it was Chris, stop being dumb. I said to them, I am not staying here. No disrespect, granny, but I can't stay here, innit? Man need shower, man need hotel, man need good stuff. You get me? Man's westernized, innit? Man, let's keep it real. I was not staying in there. You know what's there? Now, when I was going to Jamaica, everyone's like, yo, family's rich. Now, I didn't know by being rich means you got bricks in your yard. You know what's there? But man saw barbed wire on the window. I was like, that doesn't look like... That's looking a bit mad still, you get me? Man didn't have a really working toilet. Man has got to go outside and... You know what? It's a mad thing, yeah? It's a mad thing. I'm experiencing it for the first time. So I'm like, I'm not staying here. So they're like, the nearest hotel now is near a beach called Herschel Beach, you get me? For those who don't know about Herschel Beach, you get me? So I'm like, all right, cool. How far is it? Half an hour, to about hour. I was like, say nothing, bet, man's getting there, you get me? So man go there now. I'm blessed now, innit? Man's in a nice little hotel. The beach is 2 minutes away. Man's living life. Now, the moral of this whole story is I'm there to bury my granddad.